Find the area of the given polygon. Now it looks like it might be a trapezoid, but we need to verify first. So if we have a trapezoid, AB is going to be parallel to DC. So let's find the slope of each. Slope of AB goes down 6 and over 2, so negative 6 divided by 2. It's negative 3. Slope of DC, down 3, right 1. So negative 3 divided by 1. Okay, so same slope there. We definitely have a trapezoid and not a parallelogram. You can see the other two sides aren't parallel. So we're going to find the area of the trapezoid. So the area of a trapezoid is 1 half base 1 plus base 2, and then times the height of the trapezoid. So we have to calculate some different measures. We need to calculate base 1, which we'll call AB, DC is base 2, and then we'll need to figure out the height. So base 1 is going to be, you know, we're going to use the Pythagorean theorem here. And I'll just draw in a different color to illustrate. 6 and then 2. So for AB, which is really base 1, base 1 squared is going to be equal to 2 squared plus 6 squared, which is 4 plus 36, which is 40. So base 1 squared equals 40, and that means, I'm just going to go over here, square root both sides of the equation, base 1 equals square root of 40. Now we need to figure out base 2, which is this DC, Pythagorean theorem again. We have 3 vertically and then 1 horizontally, so base 2 squared equals 1 squared plus 3 squared. And 1 squared is 1 plus 3 squared, which is 9, which is 10. So B2 squared is 10. So that means B2 is going to be square root of 10. Okay, now we need to find the height. Now looking at the trapezoid, the slope here is negative 3. So we need a perpendicular for the height, which would be plus 1/3. Next, if you look at AD, that's what the slope is here, up 1 over 3. So we can use this AD as the height. So the height squared is going to be, and this right triangle is 1 and then 3. So it'll be 1 squared plus 3 squared, which is 1 plus 9 equals 10. So h squared equals 10, so h equals square root 10. Okay, now we can use the formula, 1 half, and b1 was square root 40, plus b2, which is square root 10, and then times the height, which is also square root 10. Okay, now I'm going to use a calculator for this. 0.5, which is 1 half, open parentheses, square root of 40, and then right arrow to get out of the radical, plus square root of 10, right arrow again, close parentheses, and then times square root of 10. Okay, so there's the whole setup, and if your calculator doesn't do all this, You can do radical 40 plus radical 10 first, add those, then multiply by radical 10, and then multiply by 0.5. Okay, so our area is 15. Isn't that amazing that you have all this mass and it works out to an integer? And I'm going to put units squared. All right, now that's a very cumbersome problem, meaning there are a lot of steps to it. Started off by identifying the shape as a trapezoid. And then we knew we'd use the trapezoid area formula here. And we had to identify each part and find each measure. So we had base 1 was radical 40, base 2 was radical 10, and the height was radical 10. Then we applied all those into the area formula and got our area of 15 square units.